Malia, welcome you all on behalf of the academic team to today's guest session, Make Money While You Sleep or Work Till You Die, a guest session on personal and investment finance. To help us understand about this often sidelined yet important topic, we have with us today Dr. Jalpesh Mehta, a senior finance services professional with over 2 decades of experience. He has experience in from setting up and managing various businesses across retail to international and wholesale banking businesses in India and 11 other countries. A MBA and PhD in management from Narasimha Monji Institute of Management Studies, University Mumbai, Dr. Mehta has been impacting youth through his nonprofit chapter YMF, Youth Mentors Forum, a part of Empower Foundation, which is empaneled with Niti Aayog, Government of India. Entrepreneurship, mindset rewiring to achieve goals, and spreading awareness on financial literacy are some of the passionate areas Sir likes engaging today's youth with. Now I call upon Dr. Mehta to share with the students his insightful views. Over to you, sir.
Hi, thank you, Ruth. Am I audible?
Yes, sir, you are.
So firstly, thank you so much, Dr. Swati Vispute and the academic team at Symbiosis Institute of Management Studies. Thanks, Palak Dubey, for also coordinating with me and ensuring that I'm here with you guys at 5:10 today. And thanks for the introduction, Ruth. So also, as you mentioned, I also, besides being a banker, happen to chair this non-profit called Empower Foundation, which focuses on youth empowerment. And when we talk about youth, finance also becomes a very, very integral part because I think that's the way their future could probably become more brighter if those areas are managed well and managed at the right age. So I guess today's audience is absolutely the apt audience and the right audience who probably could get an opportunity to design their financial plans, their financial goals, probably also understand what are the philosophies and instruments available for them. And as we say that probably certain things when you start young will definitely have a much, much robust and a more deeper impact in times to come. So thank you each and everyone on the call today, all the students who are there. And I hope this session is quite an enriching one for all of you. So let me share the presentation. Is that visible?
Yes, sir, it's visible.
Yeah, just give me a minute. Yeah, so Palak and myself, we were discussing that what though we want to cover the basics of personal finance and investing, what is it that something could probably move the needle inside the minds of the students that they look forward to this session? And how do we make it more interesting and more rich so that there are good amount of takeaways? So that's how we simply titled it as Make Money While You Sleep or Work Till You Die. So let me also acknowledge this is not my own paraphrase. This is a comment or a phrase said by none other than Warren Buffett, who's in today's world, probably the senior most gurus as far as investment and finance goes. So with that note, let me begin this presentation. Also, I would urge that let's try to make it interactive. And also, I'm sure you would have questions while we go through it. So maybe just note that down and probably at the end of the session, let us spare some time to answer those questions. So let me also come up with what are the key takeaways? What should everyone expect at the end of this workshop? Because that should be very, very crystal clear. And that's probably what you should look forward to. So one, I would tell you guys about what is the investment philosophy in instruments. See, having said that, most of you are from MBA background and are also getting into definitions and the core theories of it. But we will touch upon typically from a practical perspective that what are the key instruments and what are the philosophies as far as your investments are concerned. Again, something which is quite interesting throughout this session would be key 10 thumb rules. basis 20 plus years of experience of myself as an investing person, as a person who is into investments and managing personal finance. So of course, the experience of banking and also managing large clients whom we lend hundreds and thousands of crores of money also lets us understand their balance sheets and also their financials in depth. But again, from a lens of a consumer, should be 10 key thumb rules, which probably could change things for you or anyone in times to come. And most importantly, the takeaway would be that, fine, you guys are at an early stage at this point of time, and that's a wonderful stage you guys are at. Because let me tell you my example, when probably I was doing my MBA back in 2000, hardly probably besides my father or maybe a chartered account, we never knew any kind of hardcore live practical investment strategies or fundamentals. Though, of course, the subject of finance broadly touched upon the macro and the microeconomics, etc. But probably over for a hard way of learning, I could probably define in the time to come and the slides to come that how you can ensure to make money while you sleep. So I was planning to put a figure of 1 crore, but I thought that again, rather than putting an asterisk and saying that it's subject to market risk, financial instruments and mutual fund companies or equity platform would say, let me be silent on that. And let me, by the end of the presentation, show you that even at this stage, while you are doing your MBA, still not out with a job or a business or a placement in hand, how you could still plan and ensure that you have 1 crore generated simply by putting some principles in play. So the basic question which could come in anyone's mind, and ideally it should also, that why shall I invest? Let me earn, let me spend. What's the point of investing in it? We see, not probably you guys, but the alpha generation, who are probably quite young in school, are following the Western pattern where people spend most of the money. And if you look at the Americas and Europe, etc., people have amount of loans, personal loans and credit card loans on them, because they probably have a feeling that why shall we put our monies into banks or invest, rather let me spend and enjoy my life. And probably that philosophy is also coming into India. But probably thanks to our own culture, the Indian culture of saving, of conserving, has kept it as a balance. So again, to answer this question, why should I be investing? There are two answers. One is, I'll take you through that. And second is fulfillment of desires. So I'm sure you guys are aware about what inflation is. But again, to put it into a very simplistic perspective, if you can look at this slide, you have products like a liter of milk, liter of petrol, and even higher education. And if you look at it in the year 2000, a bread used to cost us 10 rupees. Today, probably it's around 30 bucks. And it's growing. If you look at a liter of milk, probably in 2000, it was around 25 bucks. Today, it's 75 rupees, and it's expected to reach 129, 130 bucks. A liter of petrol, all of us have seen the petrol prices moving year on year. And today we are almost 100. We are at 93s, and day is not far when we will be at 160, 170 kind of pricing. So historically, even look at your higher education. I don't know what is the structure of the fees these days, but probably in my time at Narsimonji in the year 2000, I had paid some 3.5-4 lakh rupees to do my MBA. I'm sure Dr. Vispati might be smiling right now, because I'm sure that the rate is off the curve. And today, probably today, if you look at the average cost of education, it's something around 26, 27 lakh rupees, or probably even more. So that's how the prices have moved, and they are also expected to move. And a thumb rule is that probably 6% kind of a increase year. That's typically what inflation is broadly defined as. And what happens is that if you keep getting an income, say, for example, month or X amount of rupees every year, but again, that income might not be sufficient to even handle the inflation. So the point is that if your costs are going to increase 6% year on year, you need to ensure that your money also grows more than 6%. Otherwise, you will be in a state where you will not be able to buy stuff or your purchasing power will go for a toss. And we've seen that. A lot of people who start at the same levels, some of them are able to conserve money and grow their wealth, and they also upgrade their lifestyles. And probably the same guy at the same grade in an organization is seen borrowing personal loan and from pillar to post to even survive for a square meal. And that's purely why he's not able to inflation. So when we talk about why one should invest, is one and only fact that inflation is something which all of us have to see, all of us have to manage. Today, probably run the house, if I have a rental of 15,000 or 20,000 rupees, that is going to increase. It's not going to decrease ever. It's definitely going to increase at a minimum 6% per annum. So keeping that in mind, obviously you might have accounted that fine, if I'm a salaried employee, my increase also will increase year on year, 10%, 20%, 15%. But there will be times when things will be flat. Look at probably the year of COVID, where most of the organizations are probably not giving any kind of increments, or they are at a staggered or a standard levels. And there could be such an, probably the income would reach a flat kind of a structure, but the cost of products and services are going to increase manifold. And the second part, why one should invest, is all of us would go through these kind of life stages. And buying a car or planning a good vacation, getting married, having kids, then probably buying a house, and probably even after buying a house, designing it in a much, much beautiful way. So every life stage, you can always, the best teacher for you to understand this is none other than your own parents. How everyone goes through these kind of life stages and how things need to be planned. Otherwise, you might not be able to achieve some of them. You might not be able to fulfill some of the aspirations. So broadly, these are the two key pillars why one has to invest. There's no choice. And also, most of you might sit for placements. Some of you might start up a business or professional roles. So of course, that will give you a good income. You will have a fixed income month on month. You'll get bonuses. You will also have a increased increments going forward. But again, that will take care of your basics. Ideally, there is always a second lever available to you, which is investment, which will be a second source of income. And those guys who create this second source of income will always and always have a much better lifestyle. They will have much more spending power and they will have much more bright future. So just imagine two people. One guy is absolutely, and both of the guys, students pass out of your college at a package of 10 lakhs or 15 lakhs or 20 lakhs, same package. One guy is probably spending money and also enjoying a great lifestyle. Guy is also doing that, but also trying to save money and making more money on the money which is being saved. So obviously at the end of 10 years down the line, you will find that the person who has been creating a second line of income, which could be through interest on deposits or through dividends on stocks or through rental incomes or various other incomes, that person will have much more comfortable lifestyle, and he would be able to take larger investment decisions like buying a house or probably buying a dream car at a much faster pace than a person who just works. And something probably even I was not aware for the first 5-7 years of my career, but gradually as we grew and we understood in the ecosystem around us that why are some bosses or some seniors doing much better, or why are some people are probably even struggling to put their kids to good schools, is purely that those guys who were able to create a second source of income through these kind of instruments were always the ones who had much more options to probably have a better lifestyle. So as they say, that one needs to de-risk the sources, because there could be times, God forbid, that a person meets an accident, doesn't work for a few years or a few months, There are times when women probably go through a cycle where they be mothers to kids and they take sabbaticals. So probably what happens? Your income sometimes is stopped, or there are chances where there are layoffs happening, or there are chances where probably one thinks that one wants to think about the whole career plan. So as they say very, very simplistically, one works very hard to generate the income, which all of us will do. And the second and the most important part is that one's money works hard to generate returns. So the person who's able to achieve both these things would definitely be at a more advantageous position. So of course, I'll not get into too many fundamentals and theories. I'm sure that is something which you guys already know or would be taught through at the business school. But broadly, to put things in perspective, what is return? So return is typically rate of return is divided by amount invested. So if I have put 100 rupees into something and I'm making 10 rupees out of that 100 rupees, then my rate of return is 10 divided by 100, which is 10%. So today, as we speak, there are various instruments in market in India who offer you returns between 4% to 30% per annum. So that might be sounding quite exciting that, wow, 30%, which means if I put 100 rupees, I'm going to make 130 rupees. But again, as I said, I'll be sharing 10 thumb rules. Rule number one here is that high risk, high return, and low risk, low return. So again, it depends on your profiles and your appetites. But this fundamental is going to be very clear that if you expect 30% return, chances of losing money also is quite high. And if someone is expecting to have a low risk into it, obviously he will not earn as much as 30%. He will have a fairly subdued returns. So that's basically the principle of risk return ratios. Now the question will be where to invest. So I'm sure you might be aware and you would have heard about various instruments, but let me take you through quickly what are the philosophies behind them and how you can probably use some of the learnings to ensure that you don't make a mistake and rather you take an advantage of something which has happened in the past to your own benefit. So one set of assets are called liquid assets. Probably all of us are aware about fixed deposits. That's one of the most well-known liquid asset, fixed deposit with banks or public provident fund, national savings certificate, debt mutual funds, etc. And also there are liquid funds in the market. They are savings saving instruments also. So when I say these are liquid assets, it means today if you've invested in these assets and you require money for your any kind of purposes, you can very, very easily move that money by dissolving that asset. So for example, savings bank account is as good as a tap available to you whenever you want to dip into that account and use the money that's always available. There are products like debt funds, liquid funds. They are also absolutely liquid in nature. Fixed deposits are there, which comes with various tenors, but you can always break them. And obviously some debt fund long-term with lock-ins because you have tax benefit on them. Because the government also wants you to probably conserve some of your finances for future and your retirement plans. So they offer you good rate of interest, much better than your fixed deposits in the market, but they come with certain lock-ins, 15 years, 10 years kind of lock-ins. The second kind of assets are the hard assets. So these are the assets which are physical assets in most, and it's not so easy to dissolve them. You can buy them, you can get good appreciation. If you need cash, you have some emergency, or there's a medical emergency, or you want to pursue some options in life, it's very difficult to dissolve these assets. So broadly, they cover real estate, which is property, and commodities like gold, silver, etc. So they also give you a good amount of returns. We'll get into a little more details on that. And of course, between the two, I've kept this asset called equities, which is basically shares, mutual funds, portfolio management services. So why are they between the two? Are they not liquid? Yes, of course, they are liquid. But they are quite hard to sell, because there are times where you might not feel that that's the right option to sell, or you might feel that you might hold it for a while to ensure that you might get more profits. So though they are liquid in nature, people tend to hold on to that, and they are not able to dissolve them as soon as they want, actually. So broadly, I take a pause here, just asking to all of you, if you have any questions so far on the said matter, maybe I can take it right now, or Palak and Ruth, you guys want me to take it at the end of the session, please advise accordingly.
Sir, we do usually take questions at the end, but sure, if there's something that you would like to address or some question that the student has, if it's okay with you, I'm sure they can go ahead.
Sure. No, as you say, so probably students can note it down, and while we go through it, maybe I might pause and maybe ask a few things so that I know how clear they are on certain things, because it's very difficult to make the session too interactive on Zoom, as probably we do in a physical format. So with that, I'll proceed further.
Sure, sir.
So again, little details on the liquid assets. As I said, debt funds and cash equivalent products, they give you returns between 4 to 8%. They are safe havens. So your monies are not at risk. The risk is quite minimal. Some of them also save you tax. So typically when you earn income on these products like FDs or even debt funds, you have to pay tax to the government. And that could vary from 10 to 30% depending on one's tax bracket. But there are some products like PPF, NSCs, where you are exempt of paying tax. But again, these are liquid funds where one probably needs to keep in mind that the returns are lower, but at least the flexibility of drawing that money is much easier. So you don't have to wait for that money to mature or the property to get sold, and it might not be as tedious to sell these assets and get cash at a tap. This specific question which a lot of people have in mind is what's the difference between debt fund and a fixed deposit? So broadly, I'll touch upon this, and this would also leave you guys with two thumb rules. So see, broadly, fixed deposits are deposits which are placed with all the banks, public sector, private sector, cooperative banks, wherein the banks would give you 6%, 8% kind of rate. So broadly, let me quickly tell you how the banks work. So they take money from you, give you 8% on it or 7% on it. And that money is again used to lend to people who want them. So that money is given to corporates, SMEs, retail consumers who want to buy auto loans or personal loans. And that is given at a much higher price. Could be from 9% to 12% kind of price. So a bank typically makes the difference between that 12% and the 7% which they are giving you. So that's called NIM, net interest margin. So that the NIM a bank makes. So of course, bank collects money from so many consumers, and they give money to people who need it. So at any point of time you want that money back, you have a required expense, you can always go to the bank and get the money in a second by dissolving that FD. So that's about FD. Debt funds are also similar in nature. It's like FDs, which are there in the bank and are quite safe. Similarly, debt funds are also a fixed income instrument, which gives you a fixed rate of return, because they are invested into good assets, typically government assets, treasury bills, government bonds, commercial papers, etc. And so typically, since the risk is low, obviously the return is also around that 7-8%. Sometimes it's seen that they give you a percentage higher than the fixed deposit, and that's why people tend to invest into debt funds. And liquid funds are also part of debt funds, but they are for a limited period of less than equal to 91 days. So they are more liquid than the normal debt funds. So broadly, let me ask you a question here. If you guys have been tracking financial services and the news around the same, anyone is free to say, talk about this. So what is this logo all about? And have you heard about any kind of crisis of late on this product or this institution? So anyone can please unmute oneself and try to share some thoughts here, please. You guys must have heard about it in the papers or in the news articles about some kind of crisis which a debt fund, which is not supposed to typically go through a crisis, went through. Anyone wants to share about it? A broad thought also would do. Not coming in, then maybe shall I proceed?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, hi. Yeah, sure. So see, typically there are a lot of mutual fund companies. They are called asset management companies. And since debt funds are supposed to be very, very safe, in the history of debt funds, there has never been a crisis, because typically they invest into AAA papers. AAA is highly respected, highly credible papers. It could be government companies or gilt funds, etc. But recently, around COVID, there was news about Franklin Templeton shutting down 6 funds. And 30,000 crore of investors' monies got stuck here. And then it was discovered that rather than investing the entire money into the so-called AAA, they had invested into also substandard companies which were A-rated and all. So in fact, they had put their money into Jindals and SL Group and even Yes Bank bonds. And obviously with that kind of a strategy, they were able to deliver much higher returns than the peers and the competitors. So for example, the debt funds of other companies were giving 7%. They were able to give 7.6%, 7.7%. So obviously, investors look upon the rate of returns and they tend to keep more money and invest more money into that scheme. But what happened is that when COVID struck in the month of April, a lot of people started withdrawing monies out of this fund and all the funds, because they were going through cash crunch and they had to pay salaries and they had to sustain their businesses. And when there was a good amount of withdrawals which were happening, and obviously Franklin had to borrow, because paisa to unhone laga ke rakha hua hai, they had put money into companies, they can't ask the company to pay. So there's a standard percentage that they can borrow 20% of the fund value, not beyond that. And they almost reached 70% levels, and then the market broke and they were not able to pay the investors. And then they had to come up with a scheme where they held back the money and they will now pay the investors in the next few months to come. So this was historic. Never ever debt funds have gone through these kind of crises, because debt funds are the most safest product available. So the rule number two here is that one should invest in reputed schemes with large AUM. AUM is asset under management with a good underlying. So typically kya hota hai, people will invest into some name and kisi chacha ne bata diya, mama ne bata diya, dost ne bata diya, kisi jagah Google mein search mara, kahin pe WhatsApp university mein koi message aaya, and people put money into some fund and then they lose money. And ideally one should go through the underlying where the money is being invested. And also people should not go for the name. So if you notice these funds, these schemes which got closed, they had a fancy names like short-term funds, liquid funds, easy return funds. So people thought that yaar ye to short-term mein paisa aa jayega, but the money is gone in the long-term. And of course, they went for a greed of few bips. Bips is paise. So kahin pe 7% mil raha tha, inko 7.6 mil raha tha, 60 paise ke liye. They lost the entire money. Hopefully they have not lost the money. They would get it back. But again, they don't get the money when they want it. So what's the point of having that money? So that's something which all of you should know while investing into a debt fund. Though the fund is quite safe, one needs to do a basic due diligence about it. Now, let me show you this picture. Anyone could recollect or anyone could comment on this picture? Now, this is much general knowledge, probably compared it to the Franklin investment. So anyone wants to unmute and talk about it? Or Ruth and Palak, do the students have that access where they can unmute and talk, or they have to raise a hand and then you guys as admins can unmute?
No, sir. They've got the access and they can unmute themselves. And
okay. Or can they chat also? They can send out a message in the chat.
Yes, so they can type anything in the chat box as well.
Super. Yeah, because it's always good to have some kind of an echo. Like I'm shouting in the valley, let me get some voices back from the valley so I know that things are going into the right perspective. So give people access whenever someone wants to talk, or maybe someone wants to throw out an answer on the chat. That also is good.
Absolutely.
May I, sir?
Yeah, please.
So the PMC Bank was in the news recently because the depositors were asking for the money and the RBI had put a cap on the withdrawals, but it was due to the management being involved in malpractices and they were favoring their friends. I don't remember the company's name, W something.
Vadwas.
Yes, yeah. Vadwas. So they were giving them funds which were not, when they were not, their creditworthiness was not determined. So that was the PMC.
Superb. Good. Yeah. Can I have your name, please?
Sir Tejal.
Hi, Tejal. Thank you so much. Fantastic. You've gone through these news. That's a good thing. And you also know the basis of why this crisis took place. So thanks for chipping in here. So yes. Typically, as you rightly said, PMC Bank had been taking money from depositors like me and you, retail consumers, giving them very good returns. But again, they used that money to give to friends and families, and those people gone bankrupt, so that money never came in. And since probably if that money didn't come in, and when depositors came asking for their money, the bank was in a catch-22 situation where they can't give money and they went belly up. So not just PMC, there have been instances of various other cooperative banks in the past, and also even Yes Bank went through a crisis kind of a time where depositors were not able to withdraw their monies. And that's something which is rule number 3 here, that one should invest in the right bank. Because see, not all banks are as good as each of them. Also, the government of India has a cap. So if you have invested 50 lakhs into a bank and that bank goes bad, you don't get that money. Government doesn't give you any assurance besides 1 lakh rupees, which has now been increased to 5 lakh rupees. That's kind of an insurance. So people lose money, and there have been people who've committed suicides because their entire life savings are into such kind of banks. So the rule number 3 here is that don't go by rate of interest. Today also there are banks who will offer you fantastic rate of returns and rate of interest, but you should invest into DSIB bank. So DSIB is systematically important banks, too big to fail. So RBI, Reserve Bank of India, has classified some banks like State Bank of India, HDFC Bank, ICICI Bank, that they are too large to fail. And typically when you invest into these kind of banks, obviously your security is much better than investing into cooperative banks or small banks. So there are so many other banks which are cooperative banks run by a smaller group of businessmen. There are so many small banks. Ideally, one should stay away from them. Even today, there are banks who offer you 1%, 2% more rate of interest, and that greed of you bips unnecessarily takes away the whole principle when things go bad. And India has a history. If you just Google about history of banking, you will find that more than 70, 80 banks have gone bankrupt. I myself as a student was not aware, but when I did my PhD into banking and it was about history, which I wanted to dive deep into, I was shocked to see that 70, 80 banks have gone bankrupt and monies of investors and depositors have gone for a toss. And obviously, every second year, you will hear about some bank or the other, even in today's scenario, who will go bad because of wrong governances and bad practices. And to put money into larger banks, safer banks, though you earn little less. So that's rule number 3. Coming to hard asset. So again, as I explained a while back, it consists of real estate and commodities, which is gold, metal, silvers, etc. They can give you returns of negative 30% to positive 30% also. So why am I saying so? Has gold ever given a negative return? No, I have not seen that. I'll show you that slide. But yes, real estate has not always been so rosy as it looks like. You will always find people, neighbors and friends and distant relative and that first cousin, etc., talking to you about that I invested into this property at this price and today the price is so high. but you will not find those same cousins and your neighbors coming into telling you that I invested into XYZ property in Gurgaon or in Delhi or even in Bombay. I know so many friends and family who have invested in the properties, and it's 20 years their monies are gone into drains. So I'll quickly touch upon that. Of course, when I talk about these assets, real estate, commodities, it's always a feel-good factor. It's a good show off or a good feel-good factor that I own a house, I own, or probably people sometimes even flaunt jewelries, etc. So though there is a feel-good factor, but again, the return could be as high as positive, also as negative to even losing principal. So of course, coming to real estate, it's an aspirational product. Everyone wants to buy a house. Thanks to our culture in the society where all of you, even myself, the generation which is going to come, will be told by their parents that, boss, you have to have a house. If you don't have a house, what will happen to you in the future? Those guys who choose for arranged marriage will be told, who will give you a spouse if you don't own a house? So all those crap will come through your way, thanks to our culture. But again, when you look at it from an investment perspective, it's not a very, very great investment instrument. I'll tell you why. It's not so easy to liquidate it. If I have bought a house and tomorrow I need money for medical emergency, or if I want to go abroad and do my second MBA, or I have my kids' education, you can't sell the real estate so easily. Appreciation is there, but in today's time, it's muted. The appreciation will be there in places where there's a very, very less supply. But if you look at places which are developing, the prices is are going to be stagnant. They would not increase. And we've seen in COVID, prices have also fallen down. There are rental yields. So if I think that, fine, let me buy a real estate and put it on rent, you get hardly 2.5%. You calculate. Kisi ka bhi aap le lijiye data, kahin ka bhi le lijiye, commercial, dukaan, ghar, आप देख लो कितना रेंटल यील्ड आता है एंड व्हाट इज द परसेंटेज इफ यू पुट द सेम मनी इनटू अ फिक्स्ड डिपॉजिट इन एफडीज यू विल अर्न 5-6% इन रियल एस्टेट रेंटल यू अर्न हार्डली 2.5% एंड ऑल्सो पीपल डोंट कैलकुलेट दीज टू इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट्स वन इज द लीगल कॉस्ट सो व्हेन आई बाय अ हाउस व्हेन आई सेल अ हाउस व्हेन आई रेंट अ हाउस देयर आर स्टैम्प ड्यूटी कॉस्ट्स एंड देयर आर मेंटेनेंस कॉस्ट सो दैट ऑल्सो एड्स ऑन टू योर कॉस्ट सो अनलाइक एफडीज और गोल्ड you don't have any cost to manage that asset. Here you also bear a cost to manage the asset. So yes, if you are investing for consumption, aap wo ghar khareed ke rehne wale hain, so that's a fantastic decision. It's always good. It's always better to upgrade one's lifestyle. But if you think that let me buy a few houses and I'll put on rent, gone are the days. Pehle zamane mein hota tha, you must have also heard from your parents and nearby is that iske paas 6 property hai, isne itni rent pe dal rakhi hai, iska to ghar rent se hi chal jata hai. Gone are the days. Abhi wo nahi hota hai. आज तो ऐसा है कि वो रेंट की प्रॉपर्टीज खाली पड़ी हुई है वो उसका हर महीने खर्चा जा रहा है बिकॉज देयर आर पीपल हु हैव वेकेटेड देयर दोस प्रॉपर्टीज पोस्ट कोविड एंड इफ यू बाय अ हाउस अगेन दिस इज पर्सनल एक्सपीरियंस आई एम श्योर योर नियर एंड डियर वंस आल्सो वुड हैव सीन दैट नेवर आई वुड नॉट से नेवर बट अवॉइड पुटिंग योर मनी इनटू अंडर कंस्ट्रक्शन प्रॉपर्टीज एंड टिपिकली द कैटेगरी बी बिल्डर्स बिकॉज देयर आर ह्यूज चांसेस ऑफ द एंटायर प्रिंसिपल द हार्ड एंड मनी going for a toss. I have seen people who lost their principal money, they have taken loan, the EMIs are going, but abhi tak khadda bhi nahi khuda hai ki ghar kab se banega. So it's very important that while buying a real estate, try to buy a ready to move in apartment or a shop or something like that. Avoid under construction property if the builder is not a very, very super A rated kind of a reputed guy. I don't know. I can't comment on the plots. I have not personally invested in them, but I know people who have invested in them. It's exactly like that movie which came a while back. I don't know whether you guys remember the name Khosla Ka Ghosla, wherein वो एक बार प्लॉट आप खरीद लेते हैं आप वहाँ जाते नहीं फिर उस असेट का क्या होता है आपको पता नहीं चलता जब आप जाते हैं तो पता चलता है कि वो आधे साइज का पड़ा हुआ है लोगों इनक्रोच करके बैठ गए So unless you have a very good connect and you have a person to control that and there are people around that plot, of course, that is also a good avenue to invest because you might have some kind of appreciation as far as plots are concerned because that at least has a better appreciation compared to an apartment. So that's broadly my take on real estate. Buy to consume, buy to stay. Don't buy to invest because you will not make money. Do the math, do the calculations yourself. And you will realize that it's a very, very simple Excel calculation. calculation to view. Coming to gold, this is another fantastic subject and the most loved product by Indians because we love yellow metal, we love gold, we are crazy about it. There was a research which said that if gold though comes from Africa, the highest reserves of gold are from Africa, but if every piece of gold in India is brought out, कुछ तो मंदिरों में है, कुछ आपके मेरे पास है, कुछ आपके मम्मी और चाची मौसी के पास होगा जो किसी को पता भी नहीं होगा, लाइक व्हाट हैपेंड इन डिमोनेटाइजेशन, द काइंड ऑफ गोल्ड इंडिया हैज इज जस्ट फिनोमिनल. एंड इफ यू वांट टू लुक एट इट, गो टू साउथ इंडिया एंड विटनेस सम ऑफ द वेडिंग्स इन प्रोबेबली केरला और हैदराबाद एंड यू सी व्हाट काइंड ऑफ गोल्ड ज्वेलरीज पीपल बाय देयर. ऑफ कोर्स अदर कम्युनिटीज ऑल्सो डू दैट एंड ऑफ कोर्स पीपल हैव बीन टेलिंग अस. आप अपने पेरेंट्स से या बुजुर्गों से बात करेंगे तो दे विल टेल यू, अरे बेटा जब मेरी शादी हुई थी तो गोल्ड 8,000 के भाव में था, आज 48,000 हो गया. मैंने जब गोल्ड खरीदा था 4,000 था, अभी 48,000 हो गया. सो दैट्स अ फैक्ट. इफ यू लुक एट दिस ग्राफ फ्रॉम 1964, गोल्ड वॉज 63 रुपीज फॉर 10 ग्राम्स, टूडे इट्स 48,000. सो इट्स अ फिनोमिनल इंक्रीज. सो पीपल विल ऑलवेज गेट किक कि बॉस ये तो बहुत बढ़िया असेट है, इसमें तो पैसा लगाना चाहिए, सेफ भी है. एंड ऑफकोर्स यार गोल्ड इज ऑलवेज सेलेबल, यू कैन ऑलवेज गो टू अ लोकल ज्वेलर, सेल देम, देर आर नो बैरियर्स टू सेल. एंड ऑल्सो इकोनॉमिकली वेन एवर द मार्केट्स आर डाउन, गोल्ड प्राइसेज गो अप. वेन एवर देर इज इकोनॉमिक क्राइसिस और अ वॉर काइंड ऑफ सिचुएशन, गोल्ड प्राइसेज गो अप. सो पीपल कैन ऑल्सो टाइम कि कब लेना चाहिए कब बेचना चाहिए, लोग टाइम कर सकते हैं. बट ये दो आप बुलेट्स देखिए, it's very interesting. If someone had invested 1 lakh rupees in gold in 1964, today he would get 7.6 crores. Exciting. And if that same 1 lakh rupees was invested in fixed deposits, he would get only 79 lakhs. But mind you, that's the data from 1964 to 2020. But if you look at the last few years, 94 say, 2020, probably you guys would have seen around, or parents would have bought at that point of time. So if someone had invested 1 lakh in gold in 94, today it is 10 lakhs versus FD which is 8 lakhs. So aisa bhi nahi hai ki boss gold is as super as it looks in the first bullet, 7.6 crore for a 1 lakh piece of gold versus 79 lakhs. The appreciation is there, it will remain, but again, it's hit a block where probably it's difficult to expect that kind of return. But now with digitization, investing in gold is very simple and easy. You get paper gold, which is exchange traded funds. You get sovereign bonds, etc. But one thing we need to keep in mind, this is a mistake most of Indians do, is that rule number 5, investing in jewelry is never investing in gold. Anyone wants to answer this? Why am I saying so? Can I mute and share the view, please?
I would like to say that, okay.
Yes, please.
It's a very, very practical and very, I can relate myself. So, we bought a lot of gold jewelry, but we never sell because, ladies are emotionally attached to the jewelry. Ye mere papa ne diya hai, ye mere isne diya hai, ye mere first salary ka jewelry hai. So, emotions are attached and we never sell jewelry. वो सिर्फ मूवी में दिखाते हैं मैं चित्र दिया बेचने
के लिए. राइट सो थैंक्स सो मच डॉक्टर स्वाति. सो यू आर राइट. सी क्या होता है, इंडियन एज अ कल्चर वी हैव द कल्चर ऑफ बाइंग गोल्ड. थैंकफुली इट्स नॉट जस्ट द माइथोलॉजी और द ट्रेडिशन व्हिच हैज क्रिएटेड द कल्चर, आल्सो द ज्वेलर लॉबी हैज क्रिएटेड दिस सेगमेंट. व्हाट वी हैव डन इज वी हैव क्रिएटेड the wedding season is the most important season to buy gold because that's a tradition. If you don't buy gold or you don't give gold, you are looked upon down by the society. And also there are a few smart days introduced by smart people jisme gold khareedna bataya jata hai, Dhanteras and Akshay Tritiyas of the world. And I don't know, there was also some recent day my mother-in-law told me that today is something called Pushya Nakshatra. Aaj gold khareedte ho to लॉटरी लग जाएगी, पता नहीं क्या क्या होगा. तो आई डोंट नो, दिस काइंड ऑफ न्यू स्टफ कीप्स कमिंग इन एंड पीपल जेन्युइनली बाय गोल्ड अराउंड दीज टाइम्स, ऑब्वियसली बिकॉज ऑफ द ऑस्पिशियस माइथोलॉजीज एंड ट्रेडिशंस अराउंड इट. बट द डिफरेंस इज दैट व्हेन यू बाय ज्वेलरी, इट्स नॉट 24 कैरेट. टू मेक अ ज्वेलरी यू हैव टू एड अदर अलॉयज एंड मेटल्स. So the quality of gold is reduced to 18 carat, 19 carat, and even if you don't buy that from a very reputed jeweler, it could be even 15 carats also. अगर तनिष्क से लेंगे तो शायद प्रॉबेबली आपको अच्छा लेवल ऑफ गोल्ड मिलेगा.
त्रिभुवन दास तनिष्क आल्सो कम्स विद 14 कैरेट्स.
ओह इज इट
14 कैरेट गोल्ड? या
सो एक्चुअली यू लेडीज आर मोर एप्ट टू शेयर व्हाट एग्जैक्टली द कंपोजिशंस आर. बट क्या होता है व्हेन यू गो एंड सेल दैट यू डोंट गेट द सेम प्राइस बिकॉज़ ए द कैरेट इज लेस प्लस दे चार्ज यू अ ह्यूज अमाउंट ऑन मेकिंग चार्जेस. So if the gold jewelry is of 1 lakh rupees, उसमें से 30,000 तो making का लग गया होगा, actual gold होगा करीबन 60,000 का. तो अब जब आप 1 lakh में 1 lakh का gold लेते हो, वहाँ पे आप 1 lakh में सिर्फ 60,000 का gold ले रहे हो. So that's a difference. So again, our parents always have a saying that we want to invest in jewelry and they keep gifting jewelries in weddings, etc. But see, I have never come across in my so many years of career that someone has sold that jewelry. Wo jewelry locker mein ya kahin padi reh jati hai. Aur aajkal to aisa hai ki you can't even wear that jewelry and go to a wedding here. The chances of you being kidnapped is higher if you do that actually, unless otherwise. So what you do with that kind of jewelry? So people have a feel ki chalo yaar maine 10 lakh ka gold ka jewelry le liya, I've invested, that will appreciate. Plus you don't sell that and you don't get the actual value because that is not 100% gold. So that's the rule number 5. Never invest in jewelry. If you want to invest in gold, invest in actual gold or a gold ETF paper. There are Government of India's sovereign gold bonds also available, which are absolutely liquid. You can sell, you save tax also on some of them. So that's about gold. Now, insurance is something which I thought I should touch upon this piece, because when you talk about investment, this also comes in hand on hand. So before I get into it, I'll show you a picture. I want any one of you to just probably chip in and tell me what do you perceive out of this picture. Isse kya aapko samajh mein aata hai? Anyone can come in. Please feel free.
Sir, I would like to take this one, if it's okay.
Yeah, please.
Sir, what I can see from the picture is that a mother is trying to protect the child from the weather, like whatever weather it may be. And in return, the child is, you know, playing carefree manner and enjoying the time.
Sure. So you're right, Tejal. The mother and child are there with an umbrella. Umbrella is something to protect the child. But the father is not there. So the mistake people usually do is that we think that insurance is a product for myself. And I'm not trying to be sexist. It's just an example that a male person who's the insured interest, if I am buying an insurance, I think it's an investment. But we don't understand in India that insurance is not for your benefit. It is not an investment product. Whoever comes and tells you, and there are people, because they are running targets, there are companies who have sales guys who will come and sell you that insurance mein aap paisa lagaiye, aapka paisa itna pad jayega. There are good plans also, they will show you good returns also in the past. But the underlying product is that insurance is not an investment product. It only is to protect your family after you. That's why I don't see a father in this picture, because this is after the father is gone. The mother is able to provide that umbrella and protect the future of the child. So unlike our traditional culture today, we will also have relatives who are selling insurance from the LIC of India old days to people working in insurance companies. So they bundle investment and insurance together, but that makes you spend a huge amount of cost. So ideally, one should buy a term plan, which is important. It is important to buy a term plan. Term plan is only to protect your future family, that if something happens to you, your family gets money. And that should be very clear that aap kal agar nahi rahe aur aapke jo har saal ki tankhwa aati thi wo kaise aati rahe aur aapke family ke lifestyle ko impact na ho. That is something an insurance is ideally supposed to do, and that is something called term plan, which is absolutely cheap. There's no cost to it. People should ideally have a thumb rule that if my annual salary is 100 rupees, I should have a 500 rupees of a cover, so that tomorrow if something happens, my family is going to have 500 rupees upfront. Jo mere 5 saal ki kamai hai, usme at least unka guzara chal jayega. So that's why this product is not for me. It's probably for my family. If I look at the picture, it's not this product will kick in only after the person is no more. And you will find amazing looking plans called ULIPs, unit linked insurance plans. Some of them save you tax. All of us would have invested. I have also invested in my earlier days. I was probably also a fool to invest into LIC plan where the first premium was given to me as a kickback, passback, wapas paisa de diya. But imagine, yaar, every money which goes every year, 20, 30, 40% of the money goes into fees. And that's how they manage the entire channel. Na? Wo jo advisor hai ya jo bhi bech raha hai, uski tankhwa, uska incentive, sab usi mein se nikalta hai. So agar aapne 100 rupaye lagaye insurance mein, pehle to aapke 30 rupaye side ho gaye, jo 70 hai, wo invest ho rahe. Versus the same 100 rupees, which you invest in a mutual fund or any other product, is invested almost 100. Not 100, there are also very small commissions, which is something I'll come to next to. But when you yourself calculate and try doing it, kabhi-kabhi koi bank mein jaoge ya insurance company wala aapse milega, aap usko bolo na mujhe comparison karke dikhana zara kya cost aayega, wo mane he will start sweating. So okay, this is a very hard way we've understood that. Rule number 6, we should never mix insurance and investment. Both are separate. Insurance is only to take care of the family post the person is no more. And if you want to invest, of course, there are a plethora of other products which gives you better rate of interest and lesser cost. Coming to semi-liquid assets, Warren Buffett again, this guy has to keep popping up because no talk of investment is full without mention of Warren Buffett. So the basic fundamental of equity should be absolutely hard-coded that the first rule is not to lose money. And the second rule is not to forget the first rule. If you guys remember this, it's the best and the boldest kind of fundamentals of investing into equities. I'll take you through this slide to bring you to a perspective. I hope it's visible. I know it's little small fonts here. But see, if you look at 1917, 1967, and 2017, in the United States of America, which were the top 10 companies? So if you look at 1917, there were companies like US Steel, AT&T, AT&T ka naam shayad aap logon ne suna hoga, kuch naam to maine bhi iske sune nahi hai. Then 1967, IBM was number one, AT&T was there, Kodak, General Motors, blah, blah, General Electric, Polaroid, Gulf Oil, etc. You look at 2017, the same top 10 companies, mein se 90% log usme hai nahi. Those top 10 companies were thrown out of the top 10 and were replaced by companies like Apple, Alphabet, Microsoft, Amazon, Facebook, Berkshire Hathaway, that's Warren Buffett's company, Johnson & Johnson, Wells Fargo, etc. So anyone wants to try to make a comment of what I'm trying to say by showing you guys this slide, please feel free to.
Sir, may I?
Yes, Alak.
Sir, if we compare the companies, like in 1997, the companies which are in top right now in 2017, they don't even exist at that time, even in 1967. But then if we see in current years, they are in the top, they are the basically top industries if we see right now.
Correct.
So that is the difference that I see.
Absolutely. So you're right, Palak, that every 30 years, 20 years, the top guys don't survive. They die. And that's a fact. Pick up the data of any country, any economy, you will see that the top 10 guys are replaced by new guys who come in. There's always a disruption in the market. There's always change which people need to adapt to. And historically, you will see new companies coming in. Also, let me correlate that and bring you closer to India, because then you will be able to correlate here. Can you see this Excel sheet? On the left side, number 1 to 10 were the top 10 companies by market capitalization in 2002. And uske niche dusre 11 companies hai. And if you look at today, 2021, the top 10 companies, okay? So if you look at the 2002, there are 5 companies like ONGC, Indian Oil, Ranbaxy, HPCL. Wo aaj top 10 to show rahe hai, top 20 mein bhi nahi aate. There are companies like Wipro and ITC who have slipped down to bottom 20s in after 20 years. And if you look at the left table, there are companies like Dr. Reddy's, BPCL, Gale, MTNL, Satyam. वो कहीं है ही नहीं टॉप 20 में, तो छोड़ दीजिए कहाँ है किसी को नहीं पता. सो इमेजिन द सिचुएशन दैट टू 2020 में देयर कंपनीज लाइक TCS नंबर 2 एज फार एज मार्केट कैप इज कंसर्न्ड, कोटक महिंद्रा बैंक, बजाज फाइनेंस, दे वर नॉट देयर इन टॉप 20 एवर. 20 इयर्स बैक में वो खुद टॉप 10 तो छोड़ दीजिए, टॉप 20 में भी नहीं थे, एंड टुडे दे आर इन टॉप 10. सो लुक एट द डेटा, ओनली 4 companies are able to survive and have their position intact. One is Reliance Industries, the second is Infosys, third is Hindustan Unilever, and fourth is State Bank of India. Baki kafi companies pehle jo top 10 mein nahi thi, ICICI Bank, HDFC Bank, they've come into top 10. And there are so many new entrants also. Adani Green, look at the point number 21. 4 saal pehle is company ka naam bhi kisi ne nahi suna tha. Avenue Supermart, that's the guy who owns DMart. Because they got listed hardly 2 years back. And look at them. They are already in the top 20. And I can tell you, knowing DMart guys so closely, the day is not far when probably in the next few years, they will be definitely in the top 10. So see, this is the point I'm trying to make, that the companies keep changing. Market caps upar niche hota rehta, and in the 20-year scenario, you will never see the same companies retaining the highest positions. And if you come to the right side of the chart, you will see that if someone would have invested 1 lakh rupees into Reliance Industries, he would have got 31 lakh rupees today. Agar kisi ne 1 lakh rupees HDFC bank mein dale hote aaj se 20 saal pehle, he would have got 1 crore 32 lakhs. 1 lakh of investment, 1 crore 32 lakhs of return. Same with other companies. So it talks about what kind of investments CAGR people have got. If you look at the CAGR, people have got CAGR of 20-25% on an average into these top companies, which is probably 5 times than the FD. FD mein aapko 5-6% milta hai, yahan pe aapko 25% mil raha hai. But yaar, the question will be that boss, how do I trust that which company will be there tomorrow? Abhi main shayad chaliye aap main sochta hu XYZ pe laga dete paisa, ye return milega kya? Nahi bhi mil sakta hai. See, that's the beauty of equity market. You can go down also, you can go up also. So, ho sakta hai ki aapka 1 lakh zero bhi ban jaye. Mere bane hue hain kafi sare stock mein. Aur ye bhi ho sakta hai ki aapka 1 lakh hai wo 1 crore bhi ban jaye. So, again, that's a very, very tricky question, that how do I decide which company I should invest in? So, to answer that, I'll also take you through this curve of Sensex. So, I'm sure you guys are aware about what Sensex is. I'll also briefly tell you that. But see, typically, Sensex is nothing but a barometer of the market. They take into consideration top 30 companies of market cap, and uske hisab se Sensex move hota hai. And Sensex at one point of time in 1987 has reached today at 50,000 levels. And if you look at this Sensex, it was 1987 mein tha. तब अगर आपके चाचा जी ने पैसे लगाए होते तो 1992 में बॉस 6 गुने हो जाते, 6 टाइम्स. बट चाचा जी हमेशा क्या गलती करते हैं कि जब 3,300 हो जाते हैं ना तब लगाते हैं, और फिर हर्षद मेहता स्कैम हो जाता है, और हर्षद मेहता स्कैम हो जाते हैं तो सीधे 3,300 से सेंसेक्स गोज डाउन टू 3,000 एंड ही लूजेस मनी एंड देन ही सेज बॉस ये तो स्टॉक मार्केट इज अ वेरी वेरी बैड प्लेस टू डू एंड ही विथड्रॉज ऑल हिज मनी आउट ऑफ द स्टॉक मार्केट एंड पुट्स इनटू रियल एस्टेट. अब वो रियल एस्टेट में जो बिल्डर को पैसा लगाते हैं वो बिल्डर जाता है भाग और खड्डा भी नहीं खुदता और वो पैसे घुस जाते हैं. एंड चाचा जी थिंक्स के बॉस आई शुड हैव प्रोबेबली पुट दैट मनी इनटू फिक्स डिपॉजिट. बट फ्रॉम दैट डे दैट 3000 सेंसेक्स जंप्स अप टू 21,000 एंड देन द अंकल थिंक्स बॉस क्या गलती कर दी, अगर मैंने ये 10 लाख रुपए यहाँ लगा दिए होते तो 70 लाख हो जाते थे, किस्मत ही खराब है. देन ही डज very simple thing, he will pull that money out of the fixed deposit. Jo builder mein paise ghus gaye to ghus hi gaye, loan bhi le liya market se aur laga diya 21,000 mein paise. Fir kya hota hai, jis din 21,000 mein paise lagate hain uncle, uske kuch dino baad sensex mein satyam scam hota hai aur wo sensex wo 8,000 point pe aa jata hai. Fir uncle kya karte hain, you guys only guess, I don't have to tell you. But today with all those ups and downs, the sensex is at 50,000. So the question will be that, boss, how should I time the market? When should I put the money? When should I withdraw money? which stock should I put money, which stock should I not put the money, because यार ये stock का भरोसा नहीं है, companies तो बदलती रहेंगी, सेंसेक्स भी ऊपर नीचे गिर सकता है, what should we do? So the very very simple answer to that is this. So as I said, Sensex is the market cap of top 30 stocks. Nifty 50 is a market cap of top 50 companies. So ये जितनी भी top 50 companies है ना, उसका market cap का total लगाइए. That contributes to around 1.4 trillion US dollars. If you add up all the market caps of all the listed companies, okay, that is 2.5 trillion. यानी कि इसका more than 50% is contributed by these top 50 companies. And if you look at India's GDP, which is around 3 trillion US dollar, half of that GDP is controlled by these companies. So boss, ये जो भी top 50 company है, ये अगर half control कर दिए तो boss कुछ तो दम होगा. And best part is, you don't have to worry. इस top 50 companies में कुछ companies निकल जाएंगी बाहर, जैसे General Electric निकल गई थी, General Motors निकल गया था US में, Apple घुस गया, या इंडिया के अंदर में ONGC निकल गया, भेल निकल गया, वहाँ पे TCS घुस गया. आपको स्ट्रेस नहीं लेना है. टॉप 50 के अंदर में कंपनीज बदलती रहेंगी, कंपनीज जाती रहेंगी, कंपनीज आती रहेंगी. यू हैव टू जस्ट सिंपली पुट योर मनी इनटू निफ्टी 50. एंड इफ यू वांट टू टेक अ लिटिल मोर रिस्क, देयर इज अनदर फंड कॉल्ड नेक्स्ट 50, व्हिच इज द नेक्स्ट 50 कंपनीज बिलो दैट निफ्टी 50 कंपनीज. नाउ क्वेश्चन इज, हाउ डू आई इन्वेस्ट देयर? सो देयर आर फंड्स, म्यूचुअल फंड्स जो होते हैं उसमें देयर आर फंड्स कॉल्ड निफ्टी 50. एंड देयर when you go and invest into mutual funds through the broker or even through the fund house, they ask you to invest into that fund. So obviously, A, this fund is safe. It will give you a good steady return. If you look at the Sensex or the Nifty for the last 50 years, you guys can always go and Google it up. Always do an Excel calculation yourself. People have got a 16-17% of a return. Because when the Sensex reached 8,000 to 21,000, then you also got a return. जब वो 21,000 से 3,000 पहुंच गया तो वो लॉस भी आपको मिला, तो बट आपका एवरेज बराबर से चलता रहा. सो फॉर दैट यू मस्ट हैव आल्सो हर्ड अबाउट दिस प्रोडक्ट कॉल्ड SIP, सिस्टमैटिकली इन्वेस्टमेंट प्लान. सो कीप इन्वेस्टिंग एवरी मंथ सो दैट द अपसाइड्स आर आल्सो प्रोटेक्टेड. कभी मार्केट की वाट लग गई, मार्केट में डाउन साइड आया, दैट इज आल्सो प्रोटेक्टेड. एंड डायरेक्ट प्लान, एनीवन वांट्स टू शेयर द थॉट्स ऑन डायरेक्ट प्लान? एक्चुअली आई विश आई कुड हैव गिवन सम काइंड ऑफ गिफ्ट इफ समवन आंसर्स दिस क्वेश्चन. बॉस माय जॉब इज डन. Anyone who wants to raise the hand, share what is a direct plan?
Hello, sir.
Yeah, hi.
Sir, I believe it's when the person purchases themselves and not through a broker. Like if you go to the website and purchase the plan as a direct plan, then it's yours and there won't be any commission directed towards the broker.
Okay, that's a good answer. Your name, please?
Abhishek Rana.
Abhishek, thanks so much. I think that's a fairly right answer. But invest directly, the same plan, nothing changes. But since it is digitally available, you can invest yourself. Then you don't have to pay brokerage commission. But brokerage is hardly 2%. Yeah, kya farak padta hai 2%? De do yaar, 2% is not big. Unlike insurance where 30-40% of your money goes. So a lot of people, even educated, I've seen a lot of people highly educated, highly qualified, they also think, yeah, theek hai na, 2% lagne do yaar. But you'll be shocked. I'll show you this table. And this is the most important table of today's evening. Just focus on this. If you have 1 lakh rupees and you invest into the equity fund, Nifty fund, you pay in a direct plan 20 paisa. 20 paisa aapka cost hai. You can invest into equity funds or Nifty fund of HDFC mutual fund, UTI mutual fund, ICICI Prudential mutual fund, इन सब के और कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ता. जो निफ्टी के 50 स्टॉक है उसमें पैसे लगाने, तो ऐसा तो नहीं कि ये कहीं अलग लगाएगा वो कहीं अलग लगाएगा. कहीं पे भी आप डाल दो, वो स्टैंडर्ड गवर्नमेंट ने बनाया हुआ है. एंड यू कैन ऑल्सो ग्रो गेट इन टू दिस फंड थ्रू पाइप्स. पाइप्स आर लाइक कुवेरा, ग्रो. 20 पैसे लेते हैं आपके. दे आर ऑल डिजिटल प्लेटफॉर्म्स. And when you invest the same 1 lakh rupees into the same Nifty 50 fund, you pay 2% commission. Aap bologe theek hai na, 2% 20%. Just look at the calculation. Spend 2 minutes on the calculation here. And then I'll make a shocking revelation, which is almost there on the screen. ₹17 rate of return. Mein se 20 paisa nikal dijiye, aapko 16-80 milna hai. Mutual fund mein 17% mein se 2% nikal dijiye, 15% milta hai. CAGR, which is compounding rate of interest, at the end of 30 years, आपने अगर 1 लाख रुपए डायरेक्ट प्लान में लगाए तो आपको 1 करोड़ मिलने वाले हैं। अगर आपने उस गरीब एजेंट के थ्रू लगा दिए जिसको आप 2% कमीशन दे रहे हो, तो इंस्टेड ऑफ 1 करोड़ यू विल गेट ओनली 66 लाख्स, बॉस 1/3, 40 लाख्स, ऑलमोस्ट 40 लाख्स ऑफ योर इनकम इज गोइंग इन टू द कमीशन। एंड डू दिस कैलकुलेशन फॉर वॉट एवर अमाउंट, ये सिंपल मैथ्स है। 1 लाख रुपए अगर 10 साल के डालने आप एक्सेल में डाल के 10 साल डाल दीजिए, एंड निफ्टी हैज गिवन द रिटर्न ओवर द लास्ट 50 ईयर्स ऑफ 15-17%, इट विल स्टिल कीप गोइंग ऑन, कंपनीज बदलती रहेंगी, आपका फंड प्रोटेक्टेड रहता है। एंड इमेजिन हाउ मच मनी यू एक्चुअली आर गिविंग। देखने में सुनने में 2% बहुत छोटा लगता है, बट 1/3 ऑफ द वेल्थ इज लॉस्ट इन टू कमीशन, एंड दैट्स अ ह्यूज अमाउंट बॉस। कहाँ 1 करोड़ और कहाँ 60 लाख 70 लाख, आपके 30 लाख रुपए तो आपने डोनेशन में दे दिए कमीशन में। So guys, the rule is very clear. You have to invest into direct plan only. Rule number 7. There's no other option. And guys, also Google it up. Aap thoda sa research khud kariye, because that's very important. Why direct plan? There's good amount of articles there, because see, the government also wants to make the mutual fund industry and investment, etc., more transparent. And when you look at a comparison with fixed deposit, jahan pe aapko 7% milta hai. Aaj 7% bhi nahi milta, aaj 5% milta hai. 7% bhi pakad liya. तो उसी 1 लाख रुपए पे आपको 30 साल के बाद में 7,61,000 मिलेगा। सो यू हैव अ चॉइस, ईदर पुट मनी टू एफडी एंड गेट 7,61,000 एट द एंड ऑफ 30 इयर्स। तब तक आई थिंक आपके बच्चे स्कूल में आएंगे या शायद कुछ कॉलेज में पढ़ ले, यू विल रिक्वायर दैट मनी। और रादर सिंपली पुट 1 लाख रुपीज इन टू अ डायरेक्ट प्लान ऑफ अ म्यूचुअल फंड एंड गेट ऑलमोस्ट 1 करोड़। सो दैट्स द अल्फा, दैट्स द डिफरेंस बिटवीन any of the investment plans which are direct plans. And typically if you look at Nifty 50, that takes care of that volatility, that takes care of the companies jo usme top 10 mein aayengi, niklengi, jayengi, koi band ho gayi, Satyam jaisi company bankrupt ho gayi, you will not get impacted. So coming to thumb rules number 8, 9, and 10, ye movie dekhi hogi aap logon ne, Scam 1992. So this guy, when I talk about investment, I can't ignore Harshad Mehta. And this is a very, very fair comment by him saying that free mein toh main mere baap ko bhi tip nahi deta. And this is another famous quote by one of my favorites, investor called Rakesh Jhunjhunwala, who says that never put your hard-earned money without proper research and never invest according to stock tips. So I have also burned my hand, yaar. I always thought that I am a very seasoned banker. मेरा तो खूब सारा connect है, ये है वो है, customer ने कुछ tip दे दी, किसी senior fund manager ने भी tip दे दी, लगा दिया। लेकिन बॉस एक चीज मान के चलिएगा कि जब आपके पास tip आती है तब तक game हो चुका होता है, you will lose money. It's always better to do your own research. It doesn't take much time. Today there are websites like Value Research, there are so many research reports available. You guys, thanks to the kind of finance curriculum you guys have today versus 20 years back, when you get out of the college, you are absolutely champions in reading balance sheets and financials and doing the entire analysis yourself. So boss, when you know how to do it, why do you want to rely on tips? So the rule number 8 is very clear. Hardcore research, then you can invest into your own stocks. Because personally, when we start working, we don't get time to monitor those stocks. And the mistake we make is that we enter into the right level, but we forget to exit. And when we forget to exit, बैंड बज गई, वो पैसा गया। एंड यू ऑलवेज थिंक दैट फाइन, लेट इट कम अप, लेट इट कम अप, लेट इट कम अप, एंड इट कीप्स गोइंग डाउन, गोइंग डाउन, गोइंग डाउन। सो बॉस, रिसर्च करने का टाइम नहीं है या रिसर्च करने का इंटेंशन नहीं है, सिंपली क्लोज योर आईज, पुट योर मनी इनटू निफ्टी 50 डायरेक्ट प्लान, डू सम रिसर्च अगेन, डोंट गो बाय डॉक्टर जल्पेश मेहता गिविंग यू दिस ज्ञान, अगेन डू सम रिसर्च, ये जो बंदा बोल के गया क्या सच है क्या गलत है, सही में डालना है नहीं डालना, पिछले सालों का रिटर्न देख लो, एंड देन at least I can tell you that you will preserve your capital and you will de-risk yourself from those companies moving into top 10, top 20, going out of top 20, top 10. You will be insulated from all the shocks of the market, be it the Satyam scan or the COVID issue. Yeah, jab aapko market upar jayega, uska bhi benefit milega. So that's rule number 8. Rule number 9. It's very important, and especially for the generations coming up. And when I also talk to school guys, when I'm sometimes schools also invite me, and I'm quite happy these days, even the government has been promoting entrepreneurship and kind of inculcating that culture of becoming startup owners right at the school levels. So that's where I am also implanted with Niti Aayog. I also see a very striking difference. There are segments of students, again, class 10 wale bache and all, they are absolutely spending money top right and center. They would buy very expensive gadgets. I don't know, parents also given to that kind of requirement. So what Warren Buffett says is that, boss, do not save what is left after spending, but spend what is left after saving. So tomorrow when you guys get placed and you start getting your salaries, start moving some money out of that as a pool, ki ye mujhe save karna hi karna hai. And jo bache usko spend karo. Let's not go to the US route where we see splurging monies and then we all are living on loans and one fine day you're not able to pay those loans. So it's very important that you save first and then spend the rest. And another thing which again Warren Buffett says, that if you buy things you don't need, soon you will have to sell things you need. A very, very deep message. In today's culture, we see people looking at each other, doing peer-to-peer comparison. Thanks to social media platforms like Facebook, Insta. I'm so thankful that I am not so much active on Insta. But I know people who will see, अरे यार ये तो Eiffel Tower के नीचे खड़ा है, चलो मेरे औकात नहीं, फिर भी मैं foreign trip plan करूँगा, loan लेकर. We should not get into that kind of rat race. The point is very clear. He is saying that you should not buy things you don't need. Or soon you will have to sell the things you will need. So it's a very, very deep message. And see, it's always good to learn from the guru of investing, because it's a hard way he's come up the curve. And today he's number one as far as investment is concerned. So it says save, save and save. So it doesn't mean that we become misers and we don't spend money and don't enjoy the lifestyle. There's always a good balance and smart people can easily do it. It's not at all a rocket science. It's absolutely a very, very simple way to manage your finance. And rule number 10, which has been the topic of today's talk, that never depend on single income. Make investment to create a second income. Because kya hoga na, aaj aapko pata nahi chalega, 10-15 saal baad you will have challenges, there'll be medical emergencies at home, parents are going to grow older, you will have needs and wants which you never thought of. There could be sabbaticals in people's life, there could be layoffs. So it's always good to create a second source of income right from today. And he also says that if you don't find a way to make money while you sleep, you will work until you die. So that's what we spoke about the topic. And what should be the investment philosophy? So of course you will want to understand that how should I do, what should I go about doing? Is that, of course, it's too early for you guys to plan short-term and long-term needs, but once you start your jobs and get into earning money, you should always plan that what are your short-term requirements, what are the long-term requirements. Simple Excel, no rocket science. And put your aspirations also, yaar. I remember when I was in the first few years of my career and I had a very, very aspiration that I want to buy a high-end car and I already had a plan in place. And kya hota hai, once you have the plan in place, you will start working for it and you will be able to buy that. Because you have a plan. If you don't have a plan, you will never ever be able to do it. Then it will only become a dream or a desire. So there's a difference between desire and a plan. And this is the mantra. You guys should start with a pool of 1 lakh rupees today. Aaj. So today, if it is 5th or 6th of February, 7th of February, you should ensure that you have a plan. In a week's time, you have this kind of money in hand. If not in a while, either borrow from the family. Maybe you guys can work part-time while you are studying. Boss, even if you go and work in a McDonald's now, you will make 10,000 and 15,000 rupees a month as part-time. So at least it's very easy to create a pool of 1 lakh rupees without any hassles. There are so many guys offering you projects along with your school where you get a certificate of experience also, where you make 15, 20,000 of stipend also. Do that. I did that when I was doing my MBA, but that was not used to invest. Usse at least mera kharch chal jata tha. I never used to take money from the parents. But if I was smart at that point of time, I would have also invested. But never the mind, I was not aware about so many schemes and products there. So ideally keep 20% of that money for some liquid investment. Aapke liye liquid investment hogi ki yaar girlfriend ka birthday aa raha hai, kuch gift dena hai, ghar walon ko kuch surprise plan karke dena hai, kuch random vacation pe jana hai doston ke saath, something like that. Try to put 60% into this Nifty 50 direct plan. Do your research yourself. एंड ऑल्सो ट्राई टू पुट इट इन अ स्टैगर्ड वे. इफ नॉट सिंगल सिंगल शॉट भी डालोगे तो प्रॉब्लम नहीं है, बट अगर स्टैगर्ड डालते हो तो अप्स एंड डाउन आर प्रोटेक्टेड. एंड देन रिमेनिंग 20% यू शुड प्ले टू लर्न एंड लूज टू विन. सो वॉट यू मीन बाई प्ले टू लर्न, दैट यू बेसिकली प्ले एंड लर्न एंड यू माइट लूज मनी ऑल्सो. स्टॉक में लगा दिया, पैसे घुस गए, कुछ नहीं, आप सीखोगे ना, यू लर्न. बट आई हैव बैचमेट्स हु ऑल्सो हैव ईयरमार्क्ड सम 20% की चलो यार ना मैं स्टार्टअप में लगाऊंगा छोटे छोटे. तो उसके लिए वो स्टार्टअप भी स्टार्टअप होता है जहाँ पे कैंटीन का जो वेटर है ना वो समोसे की का ठेला डालने का सोचता है और उसको 50,000 रुपये चाहिए होते हैं, आप उसमें 10,000 लगाते. सो फॉर यू सी स्टार्टअप इज नॉट अमेजोन एंड ऊबर एंड ओलाज यार, देर कुड बी एनी बिजनेस. सो इट विल हेल्प यू शार्पन योर अक्यूमेंट, इट विल हेल्प यू लर्न, इट विल ऑल्सो मेक यू कमिट मिस्टेक्स एंड यू कैन डू दैट यार बाई द 20%. यार वैसे तो जीरो है, आपके खुद के 1,00,000 रुपये हैं, आप तो उतना रिस्क लेके सीख ही सकते हो. 20,000 रुपीज का जो आप सीखोगे ना वो तो आपको कोई बिजनेस स्कूल भी नहीं सिखा पाएगा ना इतने लाखों में. सो ट्राई टू डू दैट, डू दोज एक्सोटिक स्टफ, व्हाटएवर यू वांट टू डू. पीपल एट माय यंगर डेज वांटेड टू प्ले मनी इन फ्यूचर एंड ऑप्शंस, चलो सीखते हैं. पैसे घुस भी गए तो यार ठीक है, नहीं लर्न द हार्ड वे. आई डोंट प्ले इन फ्यूचर एंड ऑप्शंस बिकॉज आई आई डोंट वांट टू टेक दैट काइंड ऑफ रिस्क. सो ट्राई टू डू दैट एंड इफ यू गाइस आर सीरियस, डोंट वेट फॉर placements to happen or your salaries to start, वो सब चलता रहेगा. Try to somehow get 1,00,000 rupees and try to invest yourself and you will start learning. And once you start learning it fast at a young age, things will be much, much different for you. So when to start? And this is the father of all the rules. I have shared 10 thumb rules. When to start? Warren Buffett says, I made my first investment at an age of 11. And I was wasting my time up to then. So Buffett साहब को लगता था कि 11 की उम्र में उन्होंने पहला इन्वेस्टमेंट किया, उसके पहले 11 साल उन्होंने वेस्ट कर दिए. So the mantra is you have to start now. That's it. Thank you so much. That's it from my side. I hope this would help you plan your investments and probably look at things from a different lens and perspective. Thanks. Thanks so much. I'm open to answer questions or any doubts you guys have.
Thank you, sir. We would now like to open the platform to all students for a brief question and answer session.
Sure.
You may unmute your mic and ask the question, or you can type it in the chat box and we will ask.
So I have one question.
Yes, Mona.
So basically, when you were talking about investment in property or real estate, so you suggested not to invest in that. But then, isn't it the safest option when we talk about hard assets? And isn't it the only option which will not actually depreciate in future its value?
No, so I'll answer that in two parts. See, we always have a perception that the property prices will keep on appreciating. So if I look at markets like Mumbai, there are some pockets where property prices have appreciated. But if you look at even Pune, you guys are in Pune, try to find out in certain markets which are probably outskirts of Pune. So of course, if you look at Pune, let me talk about Pune because that is something where you will be able to correlate more. If you look at a property in Koregaon Park, it will never depreciate. Wahan demand bahut rahegi, lekin supply hai nahi. But if you invest into Chakan, or if you invest into Talegaon, or you invest into the outer skirts of Pune, because there's so much of real estate coming in there, so you will never be able to get a great appreciation. And let me tell you, I have family and friends who invested in Gurgaon. I don't know how many of you guys are from North Gurgaon, Noida, good builders, JP, etc. Boss, properties are stuck. Kuch log to aisa hai ki jitne price pe liya tha, usse aadhe price mein aaj bhi mil raha hai. So it's again a factor of which market you are investing, where you are investing, what kind of supply is there. So of course, real estate sounds very smart and uber chic, that boss, I own a house and all, it's always good to flaunt. But my recommendation, if you are going to stay in the house, it makes sense. Then doesn't matter na, fir wo paisa upar ja raha, niche ja raha, aap usko bechne to nahi wale ho, aap usme reh rahe ho. And if you think that I want to buy at probably 50 lakhs or isko main 1 crore में बेच दूंगा या बेच दूंगी, तो वो आज की तारीख में पॉसिबल नहीं है, बहुत डिफिकल्ट है. इफ यू लुक एट द डेटा फॉर द लास्ट सो मेनी इयर्स, पीपल हैव नॉट गॉट दैट काइंड ऑफ अप्रिसिएशन. some properties have got that kind of appreciation. Probably before 2005, there are instances where people see, look at the gold, na, compare it with gold. गोल्ड में 1964 से लेकर 2000 तक सॉलिड अप्रिसिएशन था, लोगों के 1 लाख रुपए जो है 76 करोड़ तक पहुंच गए, बट पिछले 20 साल में 1 लाख 10 लाख पहुंचा, एफडी में 1 लाख 8.5 लाख पहुंचा. सो कभी कभी टू स्टे इट्स गुड, बट यू नेवर नो ना, बिकॉज सी कभी कभी ऐसा होता है आपने पैसा लगाया, वो बिल्डर ने प्रोजेक्ट ही नहीं लॉन्च किया और आपका जो पैसा आपने लगाया है एज अ इन्वेस्टमेंट दैट इज गॉन बैक. So it's a tricky thing. If you invest into real estate, you can, but always go for a good builder, a good property, probably ready to move in, or someone who's just about to complete construction. Because today how the situation is now, see, it's like this. If I'm a real estate builder, I'm constructing something, but no one is buying it, then I'm wasting my money. So a lot of builders have taken loan. They are not able to repay loans. They will go bankrupt. If they go bankrupt, they will not be able to complete the projects. If they don't complete the projects, you will not get your position. So what is the point of having that asset actually?
Right, sir. Understood. Thank you.
Yeah, sure. But good builders, good builders are always safe bet. You should invest into good builders because, of course, their reputation is good. They might be a little expensive. You might find builders who are expensive, but at least they will deliver.
Right, sir.
Sir, good evening, sir.
Hi, good evening.
Yes, sir. Sir, Paramveer this side. Sir, the last slide you showed about the 1 lakh corpus we should invest in principle of 20, 60 and 20. Sir, how to elaborate, sir, how to basically get that point of 60%, sir, where we should invest and in what percentage, sir, basically?
So, see, that 60% should be again into various funds. It could be into equity funds. You can invest into stock market also. See, amongst you, some people will be quite savvy. जिनको बड़ा पसंद है, जिन्होंने बचपन में यानी कुछ दिनों पहले कॉलेज में भी काफी कुछ किया हुआ है. They have time also. See, for investing in direct stock or direct equity, na, you need to have that dedication and passion. Just invest and then forget, and फिर अचानक से 3 महीने बाद आप जागोगे तब तक वो stock price ऊपर नीचे कहीं भी move हो जाता है. So for those kind of people who are not too savvy, who are not willing to give 1-2 hours every day, for them the best option is 50-50. And of course, there are so many mutual funds also. So if you think that banking as a sector is going to do well, but I don't know whether I put money on ICICI Bank or HDFC or Kotak, pata nahi maine paisa lagaya aur wo Yes Bank ki tarah koi bank fad gaya, to aap bank index pe laga do, usme sare bank cover ho jate. So your risk is hedged. If you feel that I think that infrastructure of the country is going to do well, so there are infrastructure funds. There are funds for healthcare, pharma. So see, there are two options. Either you invest directly into the stocks. उसके लिए आपको बहुत मेहनत करना पड़ेगा, उस कंपनी का हिस्ट्री ज्योग्राफी सब समझना पड़ेगा, प्रोमोटर्स, एंड ऑफकोर्स इट्स अ हार्ड वर्क बट इट गिव्स यू गुड रिटर्न. और इफ यू डोंट वॉन्ट टू स्पेंड दैट काइंड ऑफ टाइम बट यू स्टिल वॉन्ट टू एंजॉय रिटर्न्स विच माइट नॉट बी एज गुड बट much, much better than a fixed deposit and all, then you can always invest into these index funds. And again, whichever fund you invest, go for direct plan. Varna, aap apne alawa kisi aur ka ghar bhi chalaoge, usme burai nahi hai, but yaar, 1 crore ka aapka income aata hai, usme se aap 30 lakh rupaye de doge commission mein, toh yaar, it's not a great thing to do.
Yes, sir, got it. Thank you, sir.
Sir, we have a request from one of our students,
sure,
and
please.
He's asking if it would be possible for you to share the PPT with us.
Yeah, I can share that. Probably there could be some proprietary information. Either I would add some sources or maybe delete a couple of stuff, and I'll share that with you. Otherwise, I think this video is already being recorded. I was given to understand.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, I have a question.
Yes, Tejal.
I was discussing with my mother that, like, whether to invest in SIP or not. So she was suggesting, like, don't put all your money in SIPs and, like, have half of it in RDs, because most of the money that you invest in such a way, you don't usually withdraw that money for your needs. And, like, you end up in the gains from that you end up investing that money to grow your investments and like not really use it for your own purposes. And I wasn't sure how to argue with that. So what should we do about that?
No, so see, there are two thoughts. Of course, you should put your money into FD / RD or a savings bank account, and you should invest from that account. And if you think that I want some liquidity also, then do an SIP towards a debt fund, which you can always dissolve. Kabhi bhi aapko zarurat hai. So some portion can go towards debt, which will give you a lower return, 7-8% of return. And then a larger portion can go towards equity, which will give you at least much higher return than the debt fund. So okay. Ideally, agar maan lo aapne, ya chalo aapne SIP kar diya, ya maan lo aapne socha ki chalo main har mahine, rather than doing an SIP, I would invest 5,000 every month. But then you see that there's a volatility in the market and or you feel that there are some chances of markets also falling down because of XYZ reason, China war could happen, US elections can happen, etc. Then you don't invest na, wo paisa tab aapka FD mein pada rahega ya savings mein pada rahega, to at least you get 4% minimum. So your money has to earn you something. It can't lie idle. That's what I'm saying. You have to make money. It could be 4% or it could be 30%. So even if you're sleeping, you will make that money.
Yes, sir. Understood. Yeah. Thank you, sir.
Sure.
Thank you for your questions, everyone. But due to a time constraint, we will not be able to take any more questions. However, if any of you have any doubts, please approach us with your questions and we will pass them on to Sir for his views on them. We would now like to end this very, very fruitful and informative session with our esteemed guest, Dr. Jalpesh Mehta, on behalf of the Symbiosis Institute of Management Studies, for shedding light on this topic and for taking time out of his busy schedule to join us here today. I would also like to thank our faculty in charge, Dr. Swati Visprute, for her consistent support and advice. The information officer, Ms. Shweta Malhotra, Comp Lab and Academics Department for the assistance, and IT Department for providing technical support during the event. Thank you, sir. Thank you, everyone. I would request Dr. Swati Visprute to.
Yeah. Yes.
Dr. Swati, I'll just take a small second here. So yeah. Of course, this PPTs will be there with the students, but if someone wants to reach out to me with any further questions or any doubts, they can happily connect to me over these handles or even mail me. And also, you guys might have some more technical questions, or like Palak was telling me that if I could cover some taxation part also, because there could be some second year students also. So of course, if you have or if anyone has a little more detailed questions, they can connect over these handles. And also, if anyone wishes to get some kind of mentoring as far as setting up their own businesses, etc. is concerned, Youth Mentors Forum, which you see on the left side, is the chapter of the nonprofit which I chair. So there we have a set of mentors across various industries who also mentor young students who wish to become entrepreneurs or who wish to try something different. So happy to also connect with any student separately on this. So my coordinates and details are up on the screen. You guys can take a note of it. Sorry, Dr. Swati, please.
No, I just wanted to thank you for not many practical suggestions and guiding thoughts on this. And the best part is the rules. So I think it was useful to me too. So thanks a lot. Sorry for the background noise. I'm in a garden with my son.
No worries.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
Absolutely. It was my pleasure. And thanks to the entire community or the entire audience. Quite an enriching experience. I wish we could have had a physical session, but thanks to the technology, at least like most of the products are now digital. Our meetings are also happening digitally. So quite a pleasure connecting with all of you. And do reach out to me and maybe send out a connecting request, and we'll happy to connect and take it further. Thanks, Ruth. Thanks, Palak. Thanks, Dr. Swati.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.